Wir sind hier in der Werkstatt von Kurt.
We are now in the workshop of Kurt Reichmann, one of the few professional hurdy-gurdy makers left in Germany. Hello, Kurt. What started you off on hurdy-gurdy making?
Da gab es ein Festival in den 60er Jahren auf der Burg Waldeck.
In the 1960s, there was a festival at Waldeck Castle, and it was there that I first heard and saw a hurdy-gurdy. People say you can be bewitched by this instrument, and I was no exception. I wanted to play one and try to get hold of a second-hand instrument. As I was unsuccessful, I built one myself.
You've done a lot of work on the history of the hurdy-gurdy. The oldest known hurdy-gurdies were in fact organistra.
On the pilgrim's way to Santiago de Compostela, you will find church doors with sculptures in stone depicting musicians playing the organistrum and other stringed instruments.
Findet man immer wieder eine Gruppe, musizierende Gruppe, die Organistrum und viele andere Streichinstrumenten spielt. Das kam, weil
This is because the remains of St. James were found in a coffin, decorated with a group of musicians, and this is the reason behind the many organistra in the cathedrals on the way to Compostela.
Santiago überall häufig Organistren zu sehen.
Eine von diesen
Steinen. And you took the measurements of one of these sculptures.
Unter Einsatz deines Lebens, wenn ich.
Ja, das war diese, die Sie hier sehen.
Yes, it's this one here. It's a sculpture from the 12th century, but there's one in an adjacent room in the monastery that's from the 9th century.
In einem Kirch, in einem Klosterraum.
But the one you took the measurements of was particularly well preserved.
Ja, dadurch, dass eine Barockfassade.
The reason it's so well preserved is that a Baroque facade had been built in front of it, acting as a shield from pollution and salt water.
Sehr gut erhalten.
Tell us about your amazing discovery when you were measuring it.
Ja, und das war.
Yes, it turned out to be fully chromatic.
So it had semitones as well as whole tones.
Yeah, semitones too.
That's astonishing for that early period.
In der Musikwissenschaft hat man das viel später erst angenommen, die Halbtöne, aber.
Musicologists used to believe chromatic music came much later, but my findings are quite clear. The stone couldn't have been altered subsequently.
The instrument known as the symphony has been around since the 13th century. It's actually a kind of box with sound holes or openings, a keyboard and a crank or manivelle. To look at it, you wouldn't think you could play semitones on it. How did the hurdy-gurdy progress after the symphony?
Es gibt einen Beleg auf der Kathedrale in Burgos in Spanien, Nordspanien.
On the outside of Burgos Cathedral in Spain, there is a hurdy-gurdy such as you might have seen in Germany up to the 19th century.
Von Deutschland kennen, also ein Dreilier-Typ, allerdings diatonisch. Und
it's a diatonic instrument, whole tones only, and looks like an organistrum, being a corpus with two bows.
So findet man überall.
You can find evidence of hurdy-gurdies right through the Middle Ages. It was a sophisticated and expensive instrument on account of its crank mechanism.
Wegen der Kurbel. Und im 16. Jahrhundert war.
In the 16th century, however, it came to be associated with beggars, traveling entertainers and wandering women.
Umlaufende Weiberleier, viele Frauen haben Leier.
There were many female hurdy-gurdy players.
Und ja, und dann im 18. Jahrhundert kam die Schäfermusik am Hofe des.
In the 18th century, pastoral music became popular at the court of the Sun King. The aristocracy, the rich and even the bourgeoisie went down to the woods to dance to the music of the hurdy-gurdy or bagpipe.
There are also lovely engravings with what looks like your Renaissance hurdy-gurdy.
Ja, das.
These were boom times for the hurdy-gurdy. Every type of instrumental corpus was remodeled to produce hurdy-gurdies, even the lute.
Selbst damals war die Laute nicht mehr so aktuell, und dann hat man Lauten umgebaut zu Drehleiern. Es gab eine Menge von Korpusformen, viele Instrumentenbauer haben.
It's most impressive to see the various different types of corpus used. Many makers gave up producing their old instruments and turned to making the hurdy-gurdy. The result was a very special instrument with a particularly beautiful sound, the lute-shaped hurdy-gurdy.
And this was when music was composed specially for the hurdy-gurdy?
Ja, eben im Folge der Schäfermusik haben viele.
Many composers wrote for the hurdy-gurdy, following the fashion for pastoral music. Even Mozart composed the German Dance, a very nice piece of music for the instrument.
Und dann hat er die deutschen Tänzer, die sehr, sehr schön sind, für Triller komponiert.
You can still find the types of hurdy-gurdy popular in the 18th and 19th centuries.
Ja, die haben sich.
They are still around. You can see the lute-shaped hurdy-gurdy all over Europe, especially in France.
Allerdings in den Museen viele und
in Germany the shapes were simpler. But in Hungary, for example, they had very impressive chromatic instruments.
Vereinfachte Instrumente. Aber in Ungarn wieder, da waren sie wieder chromatisch und ein anspruchsvolles Instrument.
Ein berühmter Leiernbauer war Louvet.
You also have some instruments made by the famous French hurdy-gurdy maker Louvet.
Ja, Louvet war der größte Hersteller wahrscheinlich dieser Zeit.
Louvet was the greatest instrument maker of his day. He supplied the whole of the aristocracy and the wealthy bourgeoisie.
Ich will nur erinnern hier Frankfurt, ich habe eine der schönsten Trillerien, die es auf der Welt gibt, ist von Louvet.
He made one of the most beautiful hurdy-gurdies in the world that used to belong to the Rothschild family in Frankfurt.
Der damalige Bürgermeister Offenbach, der hat.
The then mayor, Mr. Offenbach, went to France to buy his own hurdy-gurdy from Louvet.
Und hat eine Trillerie gekauft. Und das war mein Glück, weil ich konnte diese.
I was lucky enough to examine and take the measurements of this instrument.
Ich konnte sie, ja.
You had it x-rayed at a teaching hospital.
Ja, the professors had great fun passing the hurdy-gurdy through a CT scanner and looking at it from the inside.
The popularity of the hurdy-gurdy wasn't restricted to the aristocracy and the court. It was popular with rather more frivolous ladies too.
Ja, das hat einmal eine hessische Geschichte und das hat eine noch ältere Geschichte aus dem 16.
That story comes from the German state of Hesse, but its origins lie in the 16th and 17th centuries. When beggars equipped women and girls of ill repute with hurdy-gurdies. This happened again in the 19th century with the so-called hurdy-gurdy girls.
Mit den hurdy-gurdy girls.
Hurdy-gurdy girls? Tell us more.
Hessische Mädchen, die von ihren.
They were girls from Hesse, sold to America by their parents. Before the German Reich was founded, there was still serfdom in the region of Hesse-Kassel. Poverty was the reason why the girls were sold in America as maids or dancing girls, but they ended up in the saloons of the gold-digging towns.
Angeblich zum als Tanzmädchen oder als in den Haushalt, aber gelandet sind sie in den Salons der Goldgräberstädte.
Prostitution was forbidden, so officially they had to do a job of work. Their job was hurdy-gurdy playing.